Hello and welcome back to another amazing episode of Fallout New Vegas. Let's get started. Okay. I just follow that objective marker and boom. That's what I do. Just follow the objective marker. Okay, let's hope nothing comes out of the wasteland today. I am going to put the settings on something else. Settings, display. I can deal with the lag a bit. It's not too bad of a lag. Like Dead Rising 3 lag. Okay. I mean, this game normally runs at 60 FPS when I'm not recording. Okay, Mr. 9 FPS. Let us see what I can do with the settings to get this to do better. Display. That's better. Oh great, now it's lagging at 14 FPS. This game normally doesn't lag on me. I don't know why it's lagging.
Done being nice. If you don't hand Ringo over soon, I'm going to get my friends and we're burning this town to the ground. Got it?
We'll keep that in mind. Now, if you're not going to buy something, get out.
What the hell is your problem?
Well, you've been causing quite a stir. Glad I finally got to meet you. Welcome to the Prospector Saloon. Looks like our little town got itself dragged into the middle of something we don't want anything to do with. About a week ago, this traitor, Ringo, comes into town. Survivor of an attack, he says. Bad men after him. Needs a place to hide. We figured he was just in shock, so we gave him a place to lie low. We didn't actually expect anyone to come after him. He's holed up at the abandoned gas station up the hill. You mean murder him? That's not our way, even if Cobb is scum. He can bluster and threaten all he wants. All right. Not much, other than they're a bunch of freeloaders who expected a few rounds on the house. I was able to get them to pay up, though. Of course, one of the great cons did knock my radio to the floor, by accident, and it hasn't been working since. They were having some kind of argument about it, but the guy in the checkered coat kept shushing them. Sounded like they came in from the north through Quarry Junction. If that's the case, I can't say I blame them for not wanting to go back. That whole area is overrun with the kind of critters that just get mad if you shoot them. Merchants avoid that whole stretch of I-15 like it's radioactive, which it could be for all I know. I didn't hear exactly, but the leader was talking about the strip. Fella wants to get there and avoid the 15, he'd have to go east. Take Highway 93 up. Sure, the outside looks okay, but I think something broke on the inside. There'd be caps in it for you. I do like to hear what's going on in the world. And that Mr. New Vegas seems like such a gentleman. Be careful out there. Feeling thirsty? I can take care of that.
Well, I fixed your radio.
Yeah, I heard it turn right back on after you got done tinkering with it. Here's some caps for the work. You're welcome. So, can I get you anything?
No.
Be careful out there.
Let me just check out my quests here.
You look extraordinarily beautiful right now. Here are our top stories. Citizens of Outer Vegas are flocking to the strip in droves amid a wave of terror caused by a band of raiders known as the Fiends. Those who can afford passports are saying the added security is well worth the price of admission. Promotional consideration for this news program has been paid for by the
gas station. Let's see here. Items. Aid.
That's close enough. Who are you? What do you want with me? Sorry about the gun. You just caught me off guard, that's all. We got off to a bad start. What say we start over with a friendly game of caravan? You know how to play? It's a two-player game, and the winner takes the whole pie. You build a caravan using the cards in your deck. The goal is to create caravan bids that beat your opponent's bids, so there's more strategy than luck involved. It's why you won't see caravan in any casino. Too slow-paced, and more importantly, no house edge. Here, take this holotape. It goes into more specifics about the rules. You'll also need a deck, so take one of my spares. So, you feel like playing a game? Don't worry. Let's play. I'm not that good of a player.
Whoa. Did I win?
Looks to me a lot if there's a Mrs. New Vegas. Well, of course there is. You're her. And you're still as perfect as the day we met. I've got news for you. Refugees at Bitter Springs are giving startling accounts of the legate known as Lanius, who is said to be Caesar's top field commander. When refugees told us the legate took over an underperforming squad of troops, by beating its commander to death in full view of everyone. The legate then ordered a tenth of his own force be killed by the other nine tenths. And you thought your boss was a pain. One more story for you. The influx of displaced residents to the refugee camp at Bitter Springs has caused a strain on rations there. Our officials are asking for donations. This program was brought to you by Gamora.
What is it? Yeah, he doesn't look very tough, though. I hear he's afraid I'll shoot him down from one of the windows when I see him. And he's right. I'll have a much bigger problem once his friends show up. There's no way I could handle all of them in a gunfight. I'm gonna lay low for as long as I can, assuming the town doesn't throw me to the wolves. I've got no chance against the gang on my own. We'd just end up sharing the same grave if it's just the two of us. Now, if some of the other people in town were also on board... Start with Sunny Smiles. She's been friendlier than most around here.
Okay. There we go. Better go talk to Sunny. She must be in somewhere.
there. Sticking around Good Springs for a while longer?
Say no more. I'm in.
Joe Cobb talks about leaving us alone if we hand over Ringo, but I know his type. He and his friends will come after the town eventually. However, between you, me, and Ringo, we aren't exactly a force to be reckoned with. A lot of people around here look up to Trudy. If you could convince Trudy to join us, some of the folks in town might decide to help out as well. I know Easy Pete's got a stock of dynamite somewhere, and Chet just got a shipment of leather armor we could borrow. Talk to them as well. Finally, there's a good chance we'll all end up with extra holes in us, so if Doc Mitchell could cough up some extra stim packs, that'd be great.
A silver tongue would help. Convincing Trudy that we had a good plan to win the fight would also help. Easy Pete's pretty protective of his dynamite. You'd have to convince him you know a thing or two about explosives before you handed it over. I don't think give is in Chet's vocabulary. Even with the town at stake, he'd still make you barter with him. I'll be waiting.
Okay.
Taking on Joe Cobb's gang. It's a big risk, but I suppose you have to do what you think is right.
Yeah, I leveled up.
I was planning on sitting this one out, but for some reason, I can't help but like you. I'm with you. Let me have a word with a few other folks, and I'll see if I can't round up some more members for this militia you're creating. While everyone does own a gun, we could stand to be a little better equipped. The general store probably has what we need in stock. Be careful out there.
Okay. Okay, what's half of 13? Ah, screw it. Keep that a kid. Better go talk to him now.
Howdy. What can Easy Pete do for you? Too dangerous. Wanna kill all yourselves if I let you touch it. Better to leave it buried. Safer that way. Yup. Keep your gun handy if you go poking around some of the abandoned places around here. Like the schoolhouse. Critters move in there sometimes.
Critters, huh? Okay. Bet you anything that that's the doc's house. Yep, I was right.
Welcome back. I had hoped you wouldn't need to come see me again so soon. What can I do for you? Seems like wherever I go, it's always the same. Folks just never leave each other alone. Oh, I'm not much good in a fight with my bum leg. And my supplies are scarce, but I'll give you what I can spare.
Blah, 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 blah.
You take care now.
All right, I will. Hey, why won't it let me use that?
Are questioning whether his pricey restaurant, the Gourmand, is overstating the fullness of its wait list. Those who claim to have dined at the restaurant find the food appealing, but say many tables remain empty. In other news, troubling news from Prim, as merchants report a large presence of armed and unsavory figures patrolling the town. Residents are nowhere to be found.
You must be the one Doc Mitchell was patching up. The way I heard it, I didn't think you'd be walking out of that office. I've got plenty of supplies for sale. Even got some weapon mods and special ammo. Well worth the caps, if you ask me. If you're hurting for caps, I've also got boxes of surplus ammo in the miscellaneous section. They're not great, but you get what you pay for. Now just hold on. I never voted to take on the Powder Gangers. That's a 1,000 cap investment you're talking about. Right. Just keep me out of it. Is there anything else?
Yeah, I'm gonna shoot you in the head.
Take it easy now.
Hey!
I better pull a gun out instead. Spurs that jingle, jingle, jingle.
So what's going on? Did Sonny agree to help us? Well, I guess that means we're ready to go. Unless you think there's something else you can do. All right, I'm ready. I hope.
Time to look alive. The Powder Gangers are here to play. I'll be set up near the store. Let's hope that the gang doesn't manage to make it that far.
All right, let's do this. Come on, man.
I owe you a huge favor for this. Here, these are technically Crimson Caravan funds, but I know they'll understand once I explain things. I'll stick around for a bit longer, but I'll be gone in a few days. If you ever visit New Vegas, look me up at the Crimson Caravan camp.
Guess that's it for now. Well, let me just check my inventory. Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and come back for more content like this. And peace out.